focus hunt for sugar, and your brain is going to take that, your body's going to take that sugar, and under orders from your brain, it's going to store it on your gut or on your butt because it thinks a famine is coming. Mm-hmm. It thinks wintertime is approaching. So protein, ingestion of protein, proper ingestion of protein, tells the brain that all is right in the world. It's summertime on the African savanna. There's plenty of food, and we can put all those nutrients into building muscle so we can go out and hunt and do all the things human beings are supposed to do. Protein is a dieter's best friend. And I hate willpower. I don't have any willpower, and I don't believe dieting or good health should be a question of willpower. Because to me, willpower is this battle that's going on in your body. And that's not a good thing. You don't want to have a battle going on in your body. Good health should be as easy as a piece of ripe fruit just dropping off of a tree. And when you give yourself high protein, and you give yourself concentrated amounts of protein, half a gram to a gram per pound of body weight, you'll find that your sugar cravings just naturally go away. If you don't have enough protein and somebody puts sugar in front of you, you can have all the willpower you want. You're going to have a tough time turning that sugar down. You'll be like, my diet starts tomorrow. And that's what most people do. But if you go to your party where there's going to be the birthday cake or the cherry pie, you go load it up on protein, it's going to be much easier to withstand the cravings and the urges and the drives, which are really hardwired in your interest. I mean, your brain is in the dark. It doesn't know it's in the year 2011 in Austin, Texas. It thinks it's on the African savanna 50,000 years ago. So you have to give the brain what it needs in order to be happy on the African savanna 50,000 years ago. So protein is chapter one. Can I go on to continue?
Let's do it.
Okay. Chapter two is fats. And just like protein is a dieter's best friend because it'll get you off the sugar, fat is a dieter's second best friend because it'll get you off the bad fat. The good fat will get you off the bad fat. Our body's need for protein is hardwired, and our body's need for fat is hardwired as well. And if you are low fat, if you are deficient in fat, and somebody puts a slice of pizza in front of you, there is no way you are going to be able to withstand that because the drive for fat is built into your brain. So what do? You get yourself essential fatty acids. In nutrition, whenever you hear that word essential, that means your body can't make it. It has to come in from the outside. And there are two fatty acids. You can just think of them for simplicity's sake as fats. There are two types of fats that are said to be essential because our body can't make it. Your body needs it. But it has to come from the outside. If you don't have enough essential fatty acids, whatever fat is sitting in front of you, you're going to go for it. Because your body's need for fat, like your body's need for protein, is hardwired. So if you want to get off the sugar, you go for the protein. If you want to get off the pizza, or you want to get off the french fries or the fat, go for essential fatty acids. Now, essential fatty acids, the role in the body, is tremendously, tremendously important. But one of the most important places where essential fatty acids play a role is they get converted into something called master hormones. And master hormones are hormones that regulate all of the other hormones. They're transcendent to all of your other hormones, and they come directly from essential fatty acids. Without essential fatty acids, you cannot make those master hormones. Master hormones regulate all the opening and closing of your body, all the opening and closing of blood vessels, nerves firing or not firing. Any kind of dynamic movement in the body is regulated by these master hormones, which in turn come from essential fatty acids. There are many Americans who go cradle to grave without enough essential fatty acids because they're so difficult to find from food.
Yeah.
If you're not supplementing, you're not getting them. You can almost one-to-one treat your fat cravings as deficiencies in essential fatty acids. So getting yourself on a good essential fatty acid is unbelievably important. There's two ways to do it. You can do it in liquid fashion. There's many brands of liquid. Or the easy way to do it is capsules, like the Youngevity product, the Ultimate EFAs. Mm-hmm. Take three capsules morning, three capsules afternoon, three capsules night. Now, one of the things that happens as we get older is we don't absorb our fats. And so many people are having problems not only getting essential fatty acids, but once they take their essential fatty acids, absorbing the essential fatty acids. So if you have a problem, then you're going to have to throw in some digestive enzymes or take your essential fatty acids with food. But other than that, as long as you don't have a digestive problem, taking essential fatty acids, generous amounts, maybe 9 capsules a day, are one of the fastest ways to demonstrate dramatic improvement in skin health, in blood pressure health, in blood sugar health, and in brain health. And it doesn't take very long. One of the neatest things, I like demonstrating to people how powerful this stuff is so they can see for themselves.
Yeah.
So here's what you do if you just want to have a quick demonstration. Get yourself maybe 9 or 12 essential fatty acids and take them all at once. And let them sit in your stomach for a little bit. Let the fats break out of the gel and go into your digestive system. And then see if French fries sound good to you. And I guarantee you, once you get a big jolt of fat into your system, essential fatty acid fat, good fat, you will not be able to eat the French fries. Now, your body is constantly using essential fatty acids, so you're going to feel like French fries a few hours later. But just doing it one time will be enough of a demonstration to show you how powerful nutritional supplementation is for weaning yourself off of the crappy stuff. My favorite thing about essential fatty acids is it makes your skin nice and soft. Now, I've been in the skincare business for a long time. One of the things about skin that most people don't recognize is your skin should never be dry. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something. Almost everybody has a problem with dry skin. There are billions of dollars spent on moisturizers in this country, which do nothing. The moisturizers don't moisturize the skin. They just wax a coating of wax or oil on top of your skin. But you shouldn't need a moisturizer because human skin is not supposed to be dry. As soon as you start taking essential fatty acids, you notice that your skin isn't as dry. The best thing about essential fatty acids for women is one of the classic signs of EFA deficiency, of essential fatty acid deficiency, is menstrual cramps. Mm-hmm. When women get on essential fatty acids, within two cycles, their menstrual cramps disappear. And this is something that happens across the board. And even better, and that's a good demonstration. That's a powerful demonstration for a woman who's had cramps all her life. All of a sudden, you get her on EFAs, she doesn't have cramps. But even better, when she takes a month off of her EFAs because she gets all cocky and says, I don't get cramps anymore, guess what? The cramps come back. That's how powerful the connection is between these physical manifestations of ill health and nutritional deficiencies.
So these are hormonal. Does it work the same for men and women?
Absolutely.
I mean, does it work in the right ways?
Heck yes. Men make hormones too. Here's how a hormone works. You have a cell, right? Think of a little circle like you saw in biology class. It's not really a little circle. It's a blob. But think of their little circle like you saw in biology class. Your little circle on the outside of a cell has little spaces. Those are called receptors. And the way a hormone works is a hormone will sit in one of those spaces the way a plug sits in a socket, mm-hmm. and it will cause a chemical reaction to happen. That's a little bit simplistic.